I think if we knew how much catch was unreported, I don't think we'd be as comfortable with how much fish are coming out to water. 75% of all fish removed from Bahamian waters is diverted towards the tourism industry here. That's fine because our population, our resident population is small, but as our resident population continues to grow and as the tourism industry continues to grow, you might hit a tipping point. It becomes an ethical question of food security in this country, right? Seafood is a major source of protein. And when you have 75% of extractions being diverted toward tourism, you need to be careful, you need to monitor this. It kind of boggles my mind that no one's written down anywhere what's the extent of fishing in the Bahamas.
The catch reconstruction done in the Bahamas established clearly the local food security, which we had neglected before. The Department of Fisheries is aware of this. Catch reconstruction study funded by Nicola Smith, but is not aware of the quantities that are involved.
There is fishing going on all over the Bahamas, yeah. And we are right now recording only a portion of it. In most instances, those fish are completely outside of our data collection system, completely outside.
A useful and a helpful first step would be to start to monitor catch from these fisheries. Without that data, you have no way of creating a policy that will be effective. If you don't know how many fish are coming out of the water, how can you tell people, well, we're now at unsustainable levels?
As a result of Nicola's work, we have a pretty good idea of that part which we were missing all along. I don't think it would be a hard sell in the Bahamas to actually go ahead and do that, to get the ministers and so forth to agree that we resubmit this information.